నమో మహావరణ్యాయ కృష్ణ ప్రేమ ప్రదాయతే కృష్ణాయ కృష్ణ చైతన్య నామ్నే గౌరత్విషే నమః. హే కృష్ణ కరుణా సింధో దీనబంధో జగత్పతే గోపేశ గోపికా కాంత రాధా కాంత నమోస్తుతే తప్త కాంచన గౌరాంగీ రాధే వృందావనేశ్వరి వృషభానుసుతే దేవీ ప్రణమామి హరి ప్రియే వాంఛాకల్పతరుభ్యశ్చ కృపాసింధుభ్య ఏవ చ పతితానాం పావనేభ్యో వైష్ణవేభ్యో నమో నమః. జయ శ్రీ కృష్ణ చైతన్య ప్రభు నిత్యానంద శ్రీ అద్వైత గదాధర శ్రీవాసాది గౌర భక్తవృంద హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే హరే, హరే రామ 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 హరే హరే. ఓం నమో భగవతే వాసుదేవాయ. ఓం నమో భగవతే వాసుదేవాయ. ఓం నమో భగవతే వాసుదేవాయ. నారాయణం నమస్కృత్య నరం చైవ నరోత్తమం దేవీం సరస్వతీం వ్యాసం తతో జయం ఉదీరయే నష్టప్రాయేష్ భద్రేషు నిత్యం భాగవత సేవయా భగవత్యుత్తమ శ్లోకే భక్తిర్భవతి నైష్టికి. కృష్ణాయ వాసుదేవాయ దేవకీ నందనాయ చ నందగోపకుమారాయ గోవిందాయ నమో నమః. రీడింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ శ్రీమద్ భాగవతం ఫోర్త్ క్యాంటో 95th చాప్టర్ టెక్స్ట్ నంబర్ 18. హిమనిర్జర విప్రుష్మత్ కుసుమాకరవాయునా చలత్ ప్రవాల విటప నలినీ తట సంపది. హిమనిర్జర విప్రుష్మత్ కుసుమాకరవాయునా చలత్ ప్రవాల విటప నలినీ తట సంపది. హిమనిర్జర విప్రుష్మత్ కుసుమాకర వాయునా చలత్ ప్రవాల విటప నలినీ తట సంపది. విప్రుష్మత్ కుసుమాకర వాయునా వైష్ణవీస్ హిమనిర్జర విప్రుష్మ హిమనిర్జరా ఫ్రమ్ ద ఐసీ మౌంటైన్ వాటర్ఫాల్ విప్రుష్మత్ క్యారింగ్ పార్టికల్స్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ కుసుమాకర స్ప్రింగ్ టైమ్ వాయునా బై ద ఎయిర్ చలత్ మూవింగ్ ప్రవాల బ్రాంచెస్ విటప ట్రీస్ Nalini Tata, on the bank of the lake with lotus flowers. Sampadi, opulent. Translation purport by His Divine Grace, S. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada ki. The branches of the trees standing on the bank of the lake received particles of water carried by the spring air from the falls coming down from the icy mountain. Purport. In this verse, the word Himanirjhara is particularly significant. The waterfall represents a kind of liquid humor or rasa relationship. In the body, there are different types of humor, rasa or mellow. The supreme mellow relationship is called sexual mellow, adiras. When this adiras or sex desire comes in contact with the spring air moved by Cupid, it becomes agitated. In other words, all these are representations of rupa, rasa, gandha, shabda and sparsha. The wind is sparsha or touch. The waterfall is rasa or taste. The spring air, kusumakara, is smell. All these varieties of enjoyment make life very pleasing. And thus we become captivated by material existence. This morning we are reading from this chapter the characteristics of King Puranjana from the fourth canto. Some of you may be wondering, what is this beautiful description of the scenic beauty explained here? In this chapter, Sri Narada Muni comes to preach to a king called Prachina Parihasa, who, as usual, like the modern people also, are not interested in hearing any spiritual sermons. So Prachina Parihasa also is uninterested to hear any spiritual discourse. As soon as he saw the Muni, he understood, now he is going to start some preaching. But our Narada Muni has different styles of preaching for different people. Like we say, you know, different shlokas for different folks. So Narada Muni knows, as per the need of the situation, how to tweak it, the spiritual knowledge in such a way that a person will become interested. So Narada Muni told him, I have not come to give you any big discourse. I have come to tell you a story, a very interesting story of one great king called Puranjan. So King Prachina Parihasa, he thought, oh, I am also a king and he is going to tell me story of a king. Maybe some lessons I will learn from it. So he became interested. And then Narada Muni began the story saying that there was a great king whose name was Puranjan. Puram means this material body. Jan means the soul who is residing in the material body. Of course, he didn't say this explanation in the beginning that he told at the end. But in the beginning he told him the king's name was Puranjan. And then he told him that in the kingdom in which he lived, there was north, there was south, there was east and west gates were there. And what are the, gopurams? This is the, like nose is the gopuram. Nose is gopuram. Eyes are like the gates which open and close. There are two gates which never close, which is nose. There are two gates which close, which is eyes. And there are two gates facing different direction. One is facing, if this is north and south, eyes, these are open to east and west, correct? No? Like that direction. So he gave all the direction very mathematically. The style of presentation was very interesting for Puranjan. Was hearing it. And he said, in that city there were a lot of grasses. What is grass? Our hair is the grass. Like that he said. So he is explaining the body to be like a city of nine gates. Navadware Pure Dehi. Krishna also says in Bhagavad Gita. So it's a Navadwara Puram. See, in the Shastras, our body is sometimes compared to a field or a city. Sometimes it is compared to a tree also. Both these can be explained very nicely. Like right now I explained to you about how this body is compared to a Puram. And we are the Puram Jan, the Atma residing in this body. The tree example is also given. Ekayana, Dvifalaha, Trimulaha, Chaturasaha, like that, you know, there is one tree, in this tree, there are two birds sitting, and then there are three gunas which act in this body. So you can compare that. It says the tree body is like a tree, and in the tree also there are holes. Sometimes you must have seen. Similarly, there are 9 holes in this body, and the tree also grows from small to big. Similarly, this body also grows, and the tree has many roots. There are 3 roots which nourish the whole tree, which are sattva, rajas, tamas, which is nourishing this material body, and antakarana, which is being maintained like that. So 3 gunas are maintaining. Similarly, chaturasaha means janma, sorry, the dharma, artha, kama, moksha. And then pancha, there are 5 senses: shabda, sparsha, rasa, rupa, gandha. Isn't it like that? Similarly, he's saying ashta vitapaha saptatvak. So that is another explanation. We are not going into that today. If you put ekayano, you will get in Bhagavatam, that verse. Ekayano, and then there is dvifala, trimulaha, chaturasaha, like that it goes. So that is another explanation about body being a tree. Here the body is compared to city of 9 gates. So while explaining the body, this verse comes. He is explaining about how in this material body made up of flesh and bones, the city, there are some pleasure points that are kept in this body. What are they? The 5: shabda, sparsha, rasa, rupa, gandha. The eyes get some pleasure while seeing beautiful objects. The ears get pleasure while hearing some sweet sounds. The nose, while smelling some fragrant objects, want to repeat that experience. Similarly, the tongue, once it tastes some object, then it want to taste more and more. Similarly, the skin, the sense of touch with the opposite sex. So these are 5 pleasure points kept in the body. And the jiva, when he comes into this world, as soon as he experiences even one of them giving a pleasure, he is like pleasantly surprised. Hey, what is this? And he wants to repeat that experience. When one gets, for example, first time, imagine you came to ISKCON, you ate a gulab jamun. One gulab jamun. You pop it in the mouth, you press it along with the juice. Oh, wow, what is this? A wow experience. So then immediately you want to repeat it. So if something is very delicious, you tend to taste it, maybe 2 dozen gulab jamuns. Somebody eats. The next day there is a diarrhea. Isn't it? Yeah. Because sense gratification is permitted for everybody in a limited way. For example, you can sleep 6 hours. You can eat a certain quantity of food. Eating, sleeping, all this is allowed. But when one goes beyond a certain limit that is allowed for the human body, then the problem arises. Like salt. Some amount of salt is required in our food. But if there is no salt, it will be very difficult for you to eat the food. Similarly, if there is too much salt, then also you cannot eat. You will spit it. Sense gratification is compared to salt. Prabhupada says this example. So, some amount of gratification is already there in our lives. Everybody has to put some food in the belly. And everybody has to get some sleep. But when one, atiseve, it is said, too much of sleep, like for example, if somebody is sitting with a computer for a very long time, especially in the late night hours, say between evening 5 to night 11, then you try to go to sleep, you cannot get sleep because the pupil has become dilated. Eyes have become, you lie down, eyes will be open only. You cannot get sleep. Many IT people will have this problem, you can ask them. Yeah, because you are keeping it, pupil gets very dilated with bright light. And when you sleep, so the doctors say that it is like ativrishti, anavrishti. Like once in Pune, we had a rain during November. Of course, some people are jolly that at least November rain came. But the farmers are not happy. You know the reason. Of course, if you are a farmer, you will know. In village, already the crops are coming up. And if the rain comes, it knocks down the crops and everything is spoiled. Therefore, everything should happen in time. Like we have to sleep with the sun and wake up with the sun. it is said. That's ideal, good habit. Similarly, the rain should, you know, the sowing the seed happens before June. Then June, July, the rain should come. Then the crops will come properly. Similarly, Ativrishti is no good. Too much rain leads to flood. Anavrishti means no rain at all. Everywhere there is dryness. Similarly, our body requires some food, some sleep, and it has to be taken in appropriate proportion. That much sense gratification is allowed. But like Prabhupada talks about sex life. Sex life is for procreation, not for recreation. When anything we go into a recreation mode, like gulab jamun, say for example, you ate 2 or 3, whatever is given, already they generally announce it as limited, which is very good for us. Limited means it is good for us, correct, no? Already the rule is kept. But somebody goes into kitchen and takes a half a bucket of gulab jamun, tries to finish it, then all kinds of problems. Then what happens? Instead of using the body in Krishna's service, you have to go to doctor. Not only you waste your time going to doctor, you also have to spend money from the pocket. So much money goes. Money goes, time goes, health goes down. All this because of too much sense gratification. Very simple, isn't it? Therefore, there has to be control in the senses. So, Prabhupada says this, too much sense gratification culture of the living entity actually is kept in order to teach a lesson to the living entity that too much sense gratification is taboo. It's not allowed. You cannot do that. If you do that, because body is a machine, just like your Maruti car is a machine, you can go at 80 or 90 kilometers per hour. But if you try to drive at 150, can you go? Maybe you can go, but not for a long time. You will burn out the car. Correct, no? Similarly, body has a capacity to digest. Now, if you can eat this much food, you eat this much food. Put like a mountain of food. I know. Because we have too much of the living entity has greed to enjoy. Actually, why the living entity is so greedy to enjoy? He is not satisfied with little pleasure. What pleasure he wants? Oceanic pleasure. He wants an ocean of pleasure he wants. But the senses are not made for that. In the material world, the senses are made for limited pleasure. But the living entity wants ocean of pleasure. Like for example, a living entity thinks that television is an ocean of bliss. He thinks like that. Why? Because there are 200 channels or 150 channels. And I can change any channel I want. And let me see what is going on here, what is going on here, what is going on here. So he thinks, oh, this I like. Oh, that I don't like. And he is making choices. By making too many choices, he becomes hyperactive also. Mind becomes hyperactive. Nowadays, the pictures also, they show very, very fast, they change. Because your mind is hyperactive, they are also cooperating with your hyperactiveness. Isn't it? Yeah. So, not only that, when you see, when one is watching, thinking television to be the source of bliss, you watch for a very long time, then there are other complications. So, the color blindness, there are many other complications. So, you will see, the material objects are not a source of bliss. They are not a ocean of bliss. It is simply the figment of imagination of the living entity. It is simply his imagination. Therefore, here it is explaining that actually, when a living being comes into this material body, he becomes greedy to enjoy with his senses. So, Prabhupada says, when one becomes greedy, naturally one needs more. When you need more than what you are allotted, then you have to resort to beg, borrow or steal. Prabhupada often used to tell this, modern man is thinking we are very intelligent, we are the ones who are doing gratification of senses. The old timers, they didn't know how to enjoy life, we are enjoying. Prabhupada, in order to prove that the old timers also tried to enjoy, Prabhupada quotes his verse, Rinam kritva gritam pibet, yavat jivet sukam jivet, Bhasmin bhutasya dehasya kutaha punaragamano bhavet. So, Prabhupada quotes this. In those days also, there were rishis who quoted Sanskrit shlokas who were atheists also. Don't think that everybody quoting shloka is a great devotee. Because there may be many people, even today there are atheistic fellows, who may even compose Sanskrit poetry also. So, long before lived one, Charvak Muni, this fellow, he said that, in this world, if you want to really enjoy life, you have to actually beg from somebody for ghee. Because ghee is actually the source of happiness, not any oil or anything. He's saying, beg for ghee from somebody and cook very nice items and eat them and live a life of happiness. And how are you going to pay back the money? That you don't worry. Even by begging, somehow you have to enjoy life, he's saying. Why? Because he's an atheist. Bhasmin bhutasya dekhasya kutam upunaragmanam bhavati. After you die, what's going to happen to you? Who knows? As long as you live, just enjoy life. Eat, drink and be merry. That's what is his atheistic philosophy. So Sudama Prabhu used to say, charvak means he walks on four legs. So this is animalistic philosophy. Isn't it? So this kind of thing, by begging and eating from others, is a shameful thing. Like for example, imagine everybody is given two gulab jamuns. But then you are asking a server, come here. Can I get two more? He asked. He said, limited. He said, at least one more. I told you, Prabhu. And he says, then everybody is watching. So we have to cut a sorry figure. And when we are greedy to enjoy more, we have to cut a sorry figure in front of public, many people. Yeah. This is about eating. See, two senses are very prominent. The sexual organs and the tongue. Therefore, I am giving you those examples. Others are not that powerful. These two are the most powerful. Prabhupada gives the example, if a man becomes greedy, even after a marriage, a man is married to a woman, marriage is permitted in Shastra. One can marry, beget children and raise them in Krishna consciousness. But if a man is dissatisfied with wife, then he is looking for another woman, a young girl, he wants to enjoy, then he gets into trouble. Either he gets a slap by the girl, or if it is already a woman who is married to another man, when she screams that this fellow is chasing after me, then all the relatives of that woman will come to beat him to death practically. The example is given in Srimad Bhagavatam. Just like the honeycomb, where a man puts his hand to take a bit of it so that he can squeeze out and drink some honey. When he puts his hand, immediately all the honeybees get disturbed. They go around him. When he runs, they also run behind him. So they are compared to the relatives of a woman with whom he tried to have illicit connection. Bhagavatam, powerful example, no? So all of them hit, attack him. They don't leave him very easily. We had gone recently to one yatra where there were some honeybees in one area. Because it's a very, very deep jungle area, where they don't want to be disturbed, and some of them are disturbed. Oh, those honeybees, devotees tried their best to run away. They chase. They don't leave very easily. So, because this man was not satisfied with his wife and being loyal to his wife, just as wife should be chaste to husband, husband should be chaste to wife too. That is the Vedic prescription. So then he has to suffer. So somebody may beg and eat. Or for borrowing, Prabhupada gives a very beautiful example I was reading, hearing. Prabhupada says, once a man went to another gentleman and said, my father actually took some loan from you. I have come to pay you back. So then the other man said, let me check my notebook whether your father really took a loan from me. Then he checked certain pages, he checked for his name. Although that gentleman happened to be his friend, he said, sorry, I don't find his name. He hasn't taken any loan. But the boy said, no, no. Just before my father passed away, he told me, my dear son, I took so much loan from so and so. You have to pay penny to penny back. You cannot keep the debt as it is. Why? Shastra says if you took a debt from somebody and you didn't pay back, next lifetime you have to four times pay back. So his father told the son. So the son and the other gentleman, they were fighting. So the other gentleman said, okay, let me find out the other notebooks, whether I have written his name somewhere. So Prabhupada says, this is India. At one time, India was like this. Now you can see, India has to be given a gold medal for corruption. In so many areas. Of course, now corruption control is happening now. In many places. But the corruption can eat up a country's culture. If it is not curbed, just like our Prime Minister is bringing about Swachh Bharat, wants to clean up the railway station, clean up the roads, clean up the homes, And if you are not keeping, if you spit also, you have to pay some money. How much it is? 500 rupees if you spit somewhere. So people are very careful now. So in the same, just as we want to keep the country clean, the money should also be clean. But if one becomes extremely greedy for more and more, then one may cheat. Prabhupada says, one president of United States in Prabhupada's times, Prabhupada says, that fellow did some fraud. Not that he was poor. He is president of a state, means he naturally must have been a very rich man. But the greed makes people adopt sinful activity, illegal activities. So, somebody is begging for ghee. Somebody is borrowing money and not giving back, thinking I can enjoy others' money. They keep on borrowing from different people. Or somebody is stealing, like the president of the United States, Prabhupada says. But all these people, going to sense gratification, they terribly suffer the consequences subsequently. They have to cut a sorry figure. So this thing should be known to us, that the sense, our senses are created like an instrument. Every instrument has a limit. Correct, no? Beyond that, if you use an instrument, even when you purchase instruments, they tell you also what is the limit. Correct, no? Of course, in those days, we didn't have this geyser having a, what do you call the thermostat or whatever? Thermostat. In those days, it was not there. If you keep the geyser on for a long time, if you don't put up the switch, it will burst or it will burn away. Correct, no? Of course, nowadays, knowing the human tendencies, they have kept this thing, thermostat type of thing. Beyond a certain time, if you keep it, it gets automatically switched off. Correct, no? Because otherwise, the people used to write, please switch off the geyser, don't keep it on, and people would never listen. Correct, no? So, because the machine has a limit, body is also a machine. Yantra rodani maya, it has a limit. Although body is a machine and it has a limit, the soul has no limit for enjoyment in the spiritual world. Because the soul has powerful spiritual senses, with which the soul can constantly delight in the spiritual world. In spiritual world, you want to eat 2000 gulab jamuns, you can eat without having any diarrhea. There is no problem. Because spiritual body has no limitation. Like Krishna says, Nainam chindanti shastrani, nainam dahati pavakah, nachainam kledayanti apo, nashoshayati marutah. My dear Arjuna, these are the physical and chemical characteristics of the soul, which is what scientists are trying to study. He says, you cannot cut the soul into pieces, you cannot burn it, you cannot wet it, you cannot dry it, which you can do with all the material objects. You can do with the material body. You burn the material body after death. Isn't it? We wet the body by taking bath every day. Isn't it? We dry the body by putting a towel. Correct? Isn't it? And people are cutting material body by stabbing or shooting. Isn't it? So all this happens. Correct or not? So you can do with material body. It doesn't happen to the soul. Just as material body has limitation and the soul has no limitation, similarly the sense gratification you can do with the material body is limited. And which is quota is prescribed. Therefore, when you talk about each of it, begging, the Shastra said, it is shameless. If you go and beg somebody, somebody may put, what to do? I don't have enough money. No, you should only enjoy what fits your pocket. That much only. Don't try to enjoy more than your pocket. But nowadays people try to enjoy their pocket more than what they have through credit card or loan. Somebody's home, you go, they say, our house is on loan, our fridge is on loan, our car is on loan, our chair is on loan, our TV is on loan, even the dress they wear can be on loan also. Everything on loan. So because of the lobh, they took loan. Therefore it is said, lobh paap ka baap hai. It is said. Isn't it? So the greed is the father of sin. So one becomes greedy and one is unable to pay back. Some people are still paying only the interest. The principal amount remains as it is. So, therefore, it is said, don't beg, don't beg, don't beg for loans. Try to fit everything within your pocket. Just like we say, cut the chappal to leg size. Don't cut the leg to chappal size. Imagine you saw a small chappal, golden color chappal in the market. You got very attracted. The only problem is chappal is too small for your leg. Your leg is little big. What you will do? Will you cut your leg to fit the chappal? or you will buy another chappal. Yeah, so actually whatever you purchase should fit within a pocket. One shouldn't beg, one shouldn't steal, one shouldn't borrow. Therefore, you will see the Vedic culture teaches about what is shameful, what is ignoble. But if one becomes shameless, then one has to enjoy more than what is allotted for us. Tena taktena bhunjita magradakasya siddhanam. Whatever allotted quota is there, be happy with that. Do not be greedy, he says. So, now I told you about the material senses and spiritual senses. Spiritual senses have unlimited ability to experience pleasure in the spiritual world. Whereas material senses have limitation. In the section of Kapila and Devahuti Samvad, there is one verse, Nirvinna nitaram bhuman asadiyindriya tarshanat yena sambhavyamanena prapannandam tamah prabho. She's telling, oh my dear master, you know, these temporary senses, which are called material senses, are like a blanket over the soul. They are like a blanket over the soul. They actually are always disturbed by seeing the objects of the senses. And I am trying to enjoy in this world, but I am fed up. Actually, all of us know this fact that we have exceeded our ability of our senses to enjoy. And we have cut a sorry figure and we have suffered also. And we have not got the good intelligence many times and we have suffered again and again, repeatedly. So she is saying that in the same manner, the living entity in this world suffers because of excessive sense gratification. Prahlada Maharaj talks about that in one verse. Kutra ashisha shruti sukha mriga trishni rupa kvedakkalevaram achesha rujam virohaha. See what an intelligent question is asking. In this world, kutra means where. Ashishaha means pleasures. Kutra ashisha shruti sukha is calling. These pleasures are only imagined pleasures which are heard. They are never experienced, is telling. Shruti sukha. Shruti sukha means like you are promised, but you have never enjoyed. He's saying. Mrigatrishni rupa. They are exactly like the mirage in the road, which appears like a river. But there is no river there, he's saying. He is saying that in this body, the shabda sparsha rasarupa gandha, these five pleasures are sought by the foolish living entity. But my Lord, this body has innumerable diseases. How can this disease-giving body give any happiness? He is asking. For example, in the material body, you will see that every limb of the body has a doctor. You can name it. For the eyes, there is ophthalmologist. For the tooth, there is dentist. For the heart, there is cardiologist. For the bones, orthopedician. For the skin, dermatologist. For the brain, neurologist. Yeah. For the kidney, there is kidney specialist. Isn't it? And for the eyes, nose, throat, there is ENT specialist. Isn't it? So in this way you can, once I was asking students almost 20 questions I asked, and for each of them they named a doctor. Which means every part of the body can give trouble. Correct, na? That is the meaning of this. Kleshada. Asannapi kleshada. Asadeh. Kleshada. Narada means he will give you Narayana. Kleshada means the body can give you klesh. That's the only thing body can give you. So one should remember this. The body is a misery producer than a pleasure producer. Body is thought of to be pleasure producing. But it can be practically proven that majority of the gifts given by the body are miseries. And the pleasures are short-lived and they are limited. And they are also obtained with great difficulty, great challenge. So now one can deny the senses, denial, as the jnanis do. So by denying the senses, one will be frustrated. And then again one will fall back to sense gratification again. Therefore, Srila Prabhupada in his lectures very beautifully explains one verse. I'll recite this. This is 1.5.33. 1.5.33. Narada is speaking to Vedavyas. ಆಮಯೋ ಯಶ್ಚ ಭೂತಾನಾಂ ಜಾಯತೆ ಯೇನ ಸುವ್ರತ ತದೇವ ಹ್ಯಾಮಯಂ ದ್ರವ್ಯಂ ನ ಪುನಾತಿ ಚಿಕಿತ್ಸಿತಂ. ಓ ಗುಡ್ ಸೋಲ್, ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಥೆರಪೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಕ್ಯೂರ್ ಎ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್? ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಭುಪಾದ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪರ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಸಮಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಕಾಸಸ್ ಡಿಸಾರ್ಡರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಬಲ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದ ವೆರಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ರೆಮಿಡಿಯಲ್ ಇಂಗ್ರೀಡಿಯಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂರ್ಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಡಿಸಾರ್ಡರ್ಸ್. ಲೈಕ್ ಯು, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಹಿ, ಯು ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಮಿರಿ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಕಾಟಮಾಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್, ಯುನೋ ಸೈಂಥವ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಯು ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ಸ್ ದ ಡಿಸೆಂಟ್ರಿ. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ, ದ ತ್ರೀ ಫೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮಿಸರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಮಿಟಿಗೇಟೆಡ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಬೈ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್. ಸಚ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲೈಸ್ಡ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಬೈ ಫೈರ್ ಐರ್ನ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ರೆಡ್ ಹಾಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಬೈ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೈರ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ಸ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ, ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸೆಪ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಟ್ ವನ್ಸ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಸೂನ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪುಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್. ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಓವರ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್, ನಾರ್ ಶುಡ್ ವಿ ರಿಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ವೇ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬಾರ್ಗೇನ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸುಪ್ರೀಮ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ವೇ ಟು ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಸೀಸಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಲಿವೇಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ವ್ಯಾರ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಮಿಸರಿ, ನೋ ಲ್ಯಾಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್, ನೋ ಫಿಯರ್. ವೆನ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದಸ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ದ ಸುಪ್ರೀಮ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರಭುಪಾದ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೌ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಅ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಹಾಲ್ ವ್ಯಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚಾಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಆಫ್, ಯು ನೋ, ರೈನ್ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಬಾರ್ಸ್, ಸಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಮಾರ್ಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಷರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಗಾಡ್. ಅನದರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕೋಥೆಕ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿ ಜೆ ಸೆಂಟರ್, ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮೇಕ್ ಅ ಹಾಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಬಾಲ್ ರೂಮ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಗೋ ಟು ಹೆಲ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರಪೋಸ್ ಇಸ್, ಒನ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಹಾಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಗಾಡ್ ಹೆಡ್, ಅನದರ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಹಾಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ಟು ಹೆಲ್. ನಾವು ವೆನ್ ದ ಮಾಯಾವಾದೀಸ್ ಸೀ ದ ಬಾಲ್ ರೂಮ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್, ಓ ದೇ ಸೇ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟಿ, ದೇ ಸೇ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ನೆವರ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್, ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಹಿಮಾಲಯಾಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡು ತಪಸ್ಸೆ. ಪ್ರಪೋಸ್ ಇಸ್, ನೋ, ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡಿನೈ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸಿಂಗ್, ವಿ ಸೇ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲೆಷರ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಮಾಯಾವಾದಿ, ಒನ್ ಮಾಯಾವಾದಿ ಗುರು, ಯು ನೋ, ಸಂಬಡಿ ಕೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸೀಟ್. ಆಸ್ ಸೂನ್ ಆಸ್ ಹಿ ಪುಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫುಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಟಚ್ ದ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್, ಇಸ್ ಆ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್, ಐ ಗಾಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಶಾಕ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಟಚ್ ಎನಿ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್ಸ್, ಈ ಸರ್. ಬಟ್ ಪ್ರಭುಪಾದ ಸೇಡ್ ಮಾಯಾವಾದಿ ಇಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎ ಡಿನಯಲ್ ಮೋಡ್. ಬಟ್ ಪ್ರಭುಪಾದ ಸೇಡ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ವಿ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಫಂಡ್ಸ್, ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್, ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಲಿಟ್ರೇಚರ್. ಬೈ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ವಿ ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಬೈ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ವಿ ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ, ಇನ್ ಮಾಯಾವಾದಿ ಇಸ್ ಡಿನೈ ಗುಡ್ ಫುಡ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಏಟ್ ಟು ಮಚ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಆಮ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ನೌ, ಬೆಟರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈಟ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಈಟ್ ಕಂದಮೂಲ್ ಬೆರೀಸ್ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಡೇ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈಟ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಟ್ ಅಟ್ ನೈಟ್, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ನಾ? ಸೊ ದೇ ಡೂ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಟೂ ಮಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ದೇ ಡೂ ಇಂಪರ್ಸನ್ಲೆಸ್. ಪ್ರಪೋಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ ಫುಡ್ ಸ್ಟಫ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಆಫರ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಪ್ರಸಾದಂ, ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪ್ರಸಾದ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರಪೋಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫೈಡ್ ಬೈ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ, ಅಂಡ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಫೈರ್, ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಸಮ, ಇಸ್ನ್ ಇಟ್? ಲೈಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಅವರ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್. ಲೈಕ್ ಬಾಯ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗರ್ಲ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಪುಟ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದರ್ ಬಾಡೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ವಾಕ್ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ, ಯು ಫ್ರಾಗ್, ಓ ಸಚ್ ಅ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಡಿಯೋಡ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಸಂಬಡಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಟು ಡೂ? ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್, ಓ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಮೈ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅವೇ, ದಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಟು ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ದ ಫ್ಲವರ್ ಆಫರ್ ಟು ಲಾರ್ಡ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಫರ್ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಓ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್. ವೈ ದಿಸ್ ಗಾರ್ಲೆಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಟಚ್ಡ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ಮೀ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಶ್ಯೂರ್ಲಿ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೂಫ್? ಪೂತನ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೂಫ್, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್? ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೂ ಲಿಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಟಚ್ಡ್ ಪೂತನಾಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್. ಹರ್ ಹೋಲ್ ರಾಕ್ಷಸಿ ಬಾಡಿ ಬಿಗೇಮ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆಂಟ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಎಂಟರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಮೌತ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಗಾಸುರ, His whole mouth became fragrant. All the fishy smell was gone. We put odonil in our lavatories. But Krishna is the supreme Neel. Isn't it? Neelamani. So Nanda Baba used to call him as Neelamani. So that supreme Neelamani rendered. If you put odonil in the bathroom, after some time odonil will get consumed. But Krishna will never get consumed because he is Vastava Vastu. Imperishable personality. Who has imperishable fragrance? So this is one sense, which is sense of fragrance. So whenever we see any material object in this world showing fragrance, you can immediately understand this is a cheating fragrance. It's not real fragrance, isn't it? So there, similarly, there are cheating flowers and real flowers. Plastic flowers people put, isn't it? They are real flowers. So similarly, not only the fragrance, the eyes get purified by seeing Krishna's beautiful personal form. Now Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur in 11th canto, one purport I was reading, he says, "My dear Lord, ever since I saw your beauty with my eyes, you have stolen my eyes away," he's telling. Which means I don't want to see any other perishable temporary beauty of this world. Similarly, he says, ever since I started hearing Krishna Katha, then all other Kukatha or Dunyadari Katha, you know, I don't want to hear anymore. I've lost taste for them. Now somebody may say, "Prabhu, I have seen Krishna's form, still I am attracted to material forms. I have heard Krishna's pastimes, still I am attracted to material, you know, stories and movies. What to do?" So this is due to avidya or ignorance. So how can we rise above avidya? For that the prescription is same. Prabhupada says here, milk and curd example he gives. You, whatever way we have been engaging, even he says that, our Patanjali says, vitarka bhavane pratipaksha bhavanam. He says that if you were attracted to heroes and heroines in movies before, now you see the supreme hero and heroine, who is Radha Vandana Chandra and Radharani. See their beauty, see their greatness, see their glory. Every limb of their body is extremely powerful. Krishna's lotus feet can destroy mountains of sinful reactions. Aham tu amsara papebhyo mokshayishyami. And he kept the lotus feet on the head of Bali and made him the next Indra. Lord Krishna's lotus feet is massaged by Lakshmi always. Similarly, the lotus feet of the Lord is so pure, by touching the waters of Viraja, the waters are rendered into Ganga, which is destroying the sinful reactions of millions of jivas all over the world. So like that, one should meditate on every limb of the Lord's body. You can see his eyes can glance, and the eyes can deliver the dead covered boys into living boys. Immediately brought them back to life. So in this way, one should meditate on how every limb of the Lord is pure. Like Lord Rama put his lotus feet on a stone and Ahilya came out. One should meditate on these pastimes. How is there any man in this world who can create a lotus from his navel and produce a baby like Brahma? Isn't it? Lord's navel is so powerful. Isn't it? So similarly, Brahmaji is telling, "My dear Lord, lying in the milk ocean, simply by twinkling of your eye, you are causing the pralaya to happen." That's all. You can set Kala in action simply by twinkling of your eye. That's all you need to do. So we have to consider how powerful. When Krishna was hearing one pastime from Yashodamaya, Yashodamaya said, "You see, Lord Vishnu lies in the milk ocean," she said. Krishna asked, "What? Milk ocean? How many millions of cows needed to come to create the milk ocean, Maya?" He asked. Yashodamaya said, No. Cows didn't produce that milk. And Lord Vishnu himself produced that milk ocean." Like that, she said. Then Krishna said, "How can I believe it? I have only seen milk coming from the cow. And you are saying, milk ocean? How can the milk come on its own?" Yashoda said, "If you ask 100 questions, I cannot continue my story." So, isn't it? Of course, for Yashoda's pleasure, Krishna is behaving like a darling of Yashoda, asking silly questions to her. So, every point she made, Krishna asked a question. But the point is, Lord is lying in the milk ocean and Brahma is watching that beautiful sight and offering wonderful prayers in 3rd canto, 9th chapter. Amazing prayer. "My dear Lord, you are lying in the milk ocean which is roaring with waves, and you are lying in Anantashesha. And Dhanantashesh is a huge snake. Who in this world can lie in a snake's body and still get good sleep? Even lying on the floor, we don't get sleep. Lying on a snake's body, can you ever get a sleep? Not only that, even if you assume that you can get sleep, imagine if the waves of the roaring waves. See, once I was lying in one third or fourth story building. Below, some two people are talking. Some two devotees are talking in that temple. Their talking was so clear in my ears, I couldn't sleep. I had to send somebody to tell them, please go and talk somewhere else. We get disturbed by small these things also, isn't it? Somebody's talk at night. But Lord Vishnu is lying in the middle of milk ocean, roaring ocean waves, and is undisturbed. Brahma is surprised. Brahma is telling that in one of the verses. I am surprised how you can sleep in this roaring ocean. That is lying. Because snake bed is also uneven also. Because the snake's coils are uneven. How can you lie down and sleep? And not only that, you can twinkle your eyes and create pralaya to happen in the whole universe. Water levels rise from the Patala Loka up to the Janaloka. All the Janaloka residents with folded palms are praying, Pahimam, Pahimam, Rakshamam, Rakshamam. They are all going to the Tapaloka, they are flying to Tapaloka. Up to Janaloka, the water level rises simply by Lord's twinkling of his eyes. So we should meditate on Lord's beauty, Lord's sweetness. Once Prabhupada was telling the devotees, and when they prepared some preparation and brought it, Yamuna Mataji made it. And Prabhupada put it in the mouth, it was so delicious. Prabhupada asked, what is it? Devotee said, Prabhupada, we have just made it, we wanted you to give a name. And Prabhupada said, this is simply wonderful, he said. Then in ISKCON it became called as Simply Wonderful. And then everybody tasted it and said, yes, Prabhupada, it is simply wonderful. And the Prabhupada said, what can I do? Your Krishna is wonderful. And Krishna's sweetheart, Radharani, is wonderful. And Krishna's books are wonderful. Krishna's devotees are wonderful. Krishna's temples are wonderful. And the holy rivers which have touched Krishna's lotus feet, they are wonderful. And Prabhupada said, everything is wonderful. Only when you turn away from Krishna, you are not wonderful. Therefore, when we are always facing Krishna, we remain wonderful. Janasya Krishnat Vimukhasya Daivat Adharmashilasya Sudukkitasya Anugraha Yeha Charanti Noonam Bhutani Bhavyani Janardhanasya. In this verse, Vidura Maitreya Samvad, in this verse he says that Janasya Krishnat Vimukhasya, when we turn away from Krishna, we become Adharmashilasya. And when we become adharmashil, we become sudukkitasya. So, excessive sense gratification is adharmashil. Therefore, we become sudukkitasya. So, as jivas, we have entered into this material bodily machine and you are pursuing some pleasure points in this body. One should know, this body does not belong to me. This body is gifted to me by Krishna. And I should know, I am a custodian of this body. I am not proprietor of this body. This body belongs to somebody else. So, then you are allotted a quota, correct? See, imagine you are a cashier in a bank. Every month you are given salary, that is your quota. But you think that, oh, today I got 5 lakhs, somebody is paying to the bank. Let me keep 1 lakh in my pocket and 4 lakhs to the bank. The same day you will be chucked out of the bank. Similarly, when we, in this body is a gift of Krishna to us. This body is functioning well. Why? Because the sense devatas, who are all ultimately servants of Krishna, they are allowing us to use this body, like the Surya for the eyes, Dig Devatas for the ears, the nose is presided by Ashwini Kumaras, the tongue is presided by Varuna, the mouth by Agni, and the genitals by Brahma, and the back buttocks by Yama. These are all different organs of our body which are presided by different devatas. And Prabhupada writes in one purport, if you use the senses in Krishna's service, that sense devata becomes very grateful to you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. If the Surya is seeing, when you take darshan of Radha Vrindavan Chandra, Surya says, thank you to you. Thank you. You are such a wonderful devotee that I gave you the eyes to see and you are seeing the beauty of the deities. When you are looking at some other impure thing, Surya becomes angry. Hey, rascal. You are using the eyes that I gave you for a wrong purpose. Becomes angry. Similarly, one uses genitals to procreate children to raise in Krishna consciousness. Brahma becomes very happy. He is the original progenitor. of mankind. But somebody is using genital for a wrong purpose, Brahma becomes angry. You want to earn the anger of Brahma? He'll be angry with four heads on your head. Isn't it? That means eight eyes will be looking at you. What are you doing? So every sense devata becomes very pleased. In one of the commentaries, Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur writes this. If you use the senses in Rishikena, Rishikesha Sevanam, Bhakti Richate. It's like iron rod put in fire, it becomes fiery. When it becomes fiery, it can burn a paper or cotton. Similarly, our body can become electrified by spiritual absorption. Then we use the senses in the Lord's service. So, one amazing thing will happen. When we use senses in Lord's service, the senses become satisfied. When the senses are satisfied, we will never be greedy. You will see devotees who become very advanced in spiritual life, their senses are so satisfied that they only accept what is allotted for them. Or sometimes lesser than that also. Like I was in Mayapur, and next to His Holiness Shukadeva Maharaj. I was telling Shukadeva Maharaj that, Maharaj, in this yatra, why are they too much gratifying our senses? They were giving three sweets that time. Dahi, mishti dahi. There was a mishti dahi, there was a Mysore pak type of thing, and one laddu also. I was telling Maharaj, why are they giving too many sweets like this? You know, if you eat all this, we will fall down. It's not very good. And Maharaj said, who told you to eat all the three? You can only accept one. And he said, see, I take only one sweet. And in Kartik time, I don't take sweet also. So he said, you have to be controlled, he said. And I liked this idea very much. Then I told another devotee that Shukadeva Maharaj told this. And that devotee said, Prabhuji, what Maharaj said is correct for Maharaj. But as far as we are concerned, you see, if you show three sweets and say, take only one, how is it possible, Prabhu? We are conditioned souls, Prabhu, you know. So therefore, we have to advance in spiritual life to an extent, to such a degree that even when sense gratification is available, we should be able to say, no. No to Maya, yes to Krishna. So that stage will come when we constantly, regularly keep on engaging our senses and mind in Krishna's service. If the senses are purified, what is the proof? They will always want to chase after Krishna. The purified senses, chase after Krishna. The impure senses, chase after Maya. And the semi-pure senses, sometimes agree to cooperate with Krishna and other times chase after Maya. You can see that. So, therefore, I heard one beautiful sentence from my spiritual master. In one lecture he said, you know, your senses always crave for sense pleasures. They are very difficult to be satisfied. But if you fill up all the holes of your body with the supreme hole, then they will become satisfied. Either is said. So eye is a hole, ear is a hole, nose is a hole, mouth is a hole. But these holes have to be filled with supreme hole. Who is supreme hole? Krishna. By filling up a supreme hole, the senses become not only sanctified, they become satisfied, they become purified, they become very thrilled and jubilant, and the senses become very joyful. Because what they deserve is only Krishna, who is unlimited. Because Krishna is unlimited, you can get unlimited sense gratification through eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin by connecting with Krishna, who is the supreme whole. So Srila Prabhupada gave this beautiful method of how the disease caused by milk can be solved by dahi or curd. Similarly, Prabhupada taught us how to use our senses in Krishna service, by which we can do innumerable activities in Krishna consciousness movement, and we can become purified, more purified, most purified, and completely absorbed in Krishna to an extent that we will not take birth again in this world. The Krishna conscious process is like a disinfectant, or like a, what do you call that injection they give, special injection in villages they give? Vaccine, yeah. It's like a vaccination, chanting the holy name, hearing the Bhagavatam class, and living in the company of devotees, taking darshan of deities. Every one of these things is like a vaccination for the soul. The soul is protected, the subtle body is purified, and the senses are controlled. In this way, one becomes stably situated in Krishna consciousness, heading progressively towards the spiritual world. శ్రీ ప్రభుపాదికి, మంత్రాక్షమద్ భాగవతంకి, గౌరభక్తవృందకి థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్.